Then the next question pops in. How much time are you realistically willing and able to spend training, dieting, cooking, whatever it is, in an effort to achieve your goals? Big question, huh? How much time are you realistically willing and able to spend training? I get a lot of people that come to me saying, I can go to gym 3 times a week for an hour. I can exercise 3 times a week for an hour. And these are usually moms, 1 or 2 kids. And I just go, no, you can't. You don't have the time to spend 3 or 4 hours a week training for most people, unless you have like help and all that sort of stuff and you can maybe make it work. But most women especially have other things to do. Guys tend to have jobs. Women tend to have a million things to do, including jobs. And in my case, with the women I deal with, baby duties and toddler duties and all that sort of stuff. So how much time are you realistically willing and able to spend training in an effort to achieve your goals? Now, if you're talking about weight loss, we're not just talking training, right? We're talking cooking and all that sort of stuff. How much time are you realistically willing and able to spend cooking in an effort to achieve your weight loss goal? How much time are you willing and able to spend planning your weekly meals in an effort to achieve your goal? So how much time are you with regards to mental health? How much time are you realistically willing and able to spend meditating in an effort to achieve your goal of improved mental health? That is the question you're asking. How much time are you going to put in? Now, remember, you told me what your goals were. You said to yourself why these are your goals. You said how determined you are to reach those goals, right? So if you say I'm a 10 on a scale of 1 to 10, I'm a 10 and determined how to reach my goal, and then you tell me you only want to spend 2 or 3 hours working on your goal, and those two things are not really compatible, right? If you're a level 10 determined, level 9, 10 determined, you're willing to do whatever it takes. How much time you're realistically willing and able to spend? However much time you want me to spend in there, Peter. That is the answer. How much time? I've had clients coming to me before, and we're talking like slightly higher end, financially very secure clients whose main goal for their work is to look a certain way or to feel a certain way. And they will do whatever I tell them to do. You know, people that work towards movies and all that sort of stuff. Like again, Olympic level athletes, they are willing to do whatever it takes to achieve that goal, to spend however much time it really takes. Andy Murray spends 4 or 5 hours a day training, or used to before he messed up his hip. What are you willing to sacrifice? Yeah, I won't see my daughter being born, but that's what I'm willing to do because I'm training this afternoon doing leg presses. Do you know what I mean? So again, write that down and make sure everything matches up. Don't lie to yourself. If you say I can commit 2 hours a week to achieving my goal, then that is fine. There is no right or wrong here. There is no catch. There is no trap. It's all very straightforward stuff. Right? So then we get to the next question, which is what obstacles can you think of that might prevent you from reaching your goals? Of course, on your scale of 1 to 10 determined, you're 10 determined. There's nothing that gets in the way because everything gets cancelled. But for most normal people, things like big events, meals out, parties, all that sort of stuff, 50th birthday party coming up, 40th birthday party coming up, work deadlines for a lot of people. They've got stuff to do. They've got a busy job, a lot of my clients. I have a couple of toddlers running around. That sort of stuff can be an obstacle to you exercising a lot, having to take care of your kids. Nights out, lack of dietary knowledge, not knowing how to cook. If you're talking weight loss, not knowing how to cook your own food is an obstacle to weight loss. Not being in the right frame of mind is an obstacle to reaching your goals. Always, with regards to, say, your mental health is struggling, suffering from anxiety and depression, that can really get in the way of any sort of health and fitness goals, right? You have to account for that stuff. So let's write that down. What obstacles can you think of? And this is, if you're honestly, and if most people are honest about this, this can be quite the list. I don't trust people that say none. Because if you tell me your scale of 1 to 10, you're 8 or 9 plus determined, and you can't think of any obstacles, then you would already be an Olympic level athlete or have achieved your goals. There isn't a single person out there that is level 10 determined, that has no obstacles, that hasn't already started. Right? That is not level 10. It just isn't. But write down your obstacles. And again, it doesn't matter how many there are. We'll overcome them all.